Let's look at an introduction to the Poisson distribution, another important discrete probability distribution. Asteroids with a diameter of at least 1 kilometer collide with the Earth at a rate of approximately 2 per million years. We might be interested in the probability that a randomly selected million-year period there is exactly one collision, or we could be interested in different time periods or what have you, and under certain conditions, the Poisson distribution would help us out here. Suppose that events are occurring independently in time, and that the probability that an event occurs in a given length of time does not change through time, then X, the number of occurrences in a fixed unit of time, has a Poisson distribution. This notation, or the probability that the random variable x takes on the value little x, confuses people at times, so sometimes we just loosen it up and say the probability of little x is equal to this quantity over here. Now, E is an important mathematical constant, the base of natural logarithms, and it is approximately 2.71828. It takes on infinite decimal places, goes on and on and on and on here, this type of thing. And comes up very, very frequently in the world of mathematics. I hope you're familiar with the term x factorial. As a specific example, let's say 5 factorial is simply equal to 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1, which is 120. And lambda is simply the mean number of occurrences in the time frame that we're talking about. So our lambda is actually mu, so notation-wise we could have used mu, but very commonly people use lambda in here. And the mean is equal to lambda, but also the variance is equal to lambda. So yes, for a Poisson distribution, the mean and the variance are equal. And one thing we should note here is, for what values does this actually work? And this is only true for x, values of x, 0, 1, 2, all the way off to infinity. So there is no upper bound here. We're counting up the number of times something happens, so we're going to have the minimum of 0, and then 1 and 2 and 3, but there's no upper bound that's going off to infinity. So let's return to our example here. Asteroids with a diameter of at least 1 kilometer collide with the Earth at a rate of approximately 2 per million years, and we want to know what is the probability that in a randomly selected million-year period there is exactly one collision. Well, the Poisson distribution may very well provide a reasonable approximation in these spots. Probably not exactly perfectly true. Are these collisions occurring independently of one another? That's debatable, all the rest of it. But it might provide us with a reasonable approximation anyway. So if the Poisson distribution is reasonable here, then we are simply interested in the probability that x is equal to 1, where x is our random variable representing the number of collisions. And we have a million-year period. We are interested in a million-year period. And the mean number of occurrences in that million-year period is 2. Lambda is 2, the mean number of occurrences in the time frame we're talking about. You got to be a little careful because sometimes the question asks for a different period than is given up here. But in this case, it's simple and it's simply an average of 2 per million years. And we want to know the probability that x is equal to 1. This is our lambda to the x, e to the minus lambda over x factorial. And this just equals 2 to the first power, e to the minus 2 over 1 factorial. And if you put that into your calculator, you would see that this is simply 0.2707. And there we go. We have our answer and we're done with this particular question. Now, if we calculated the probability of all the different possible values and plotted them out, we'd get something like this. Now, it's tough to actually do it for all of them because this is going off to infinity, but just if we chop it off at 10 here, this is what it looks like. We just calculated this probability over here, the probability of getting exactly 1. The probability of getting exactly 1, and that was approximately 0.27. And we can see here the relative likelihood of these different number of occurrences. And of course, once you start getting up to a big number here, that's quite unlikely. So let's try to get a little bit of a feel for when the Poisson distribution might be reasonable and when it's not. So in this particular plot, we've got randomly plotted data points here. So just a random selection of a x value, random selection of a y value, plotted them out. They're all occurring randomly and independently of one another here. And let's envision this as a field where there's something that's occurring purely randomly in this field. And if we were to randomly select, suppose, a square meter of this field, where the red square represents a square meter, in this particular one, there are 4 occurrences in that square meter. And if we randomly selected another square meter, In that particular one, there is one occurrence. If we randomly selected another square meter, in that particular one, there are two occurrences. And these randomly selected square meters contain a certain number of occurrences. And if these points are occurring purely randomly and independently of one another at the same rate across the entire field, then the number of occurrences in a randomly selected square meter is indeed going to follow a Poisson distribution. But let's see what happens when they are not occurring purely randomly and independently of one another. Suppose we have a situation where there's a little clumping going on. So it might look like this. Maybe some plants are clumping together in different areas. Maybe cows in a field are accumulating together. This type of idea. And we've got a little clumping. There isn't random scattering. There's some randomness in there, but they're in clumps. And so if we were to randomly select a plot here, a lot of the times we're going to get no occurrences. There's a lot of black area there where we're just going to get zero occurrences. But if we randomly select another one, well, sometimes we're going to get a whole lot of occurrences, and sometimes we're going to get just a couple, but we're going to get a lot of zeros and a lot of big counts, too. And so since they're not randomly scattered throughout the area, this is not going to follow a Poisson distribution. The number of occurrences in these randomly selected boxes is not going to follow a Poisson distribution. On the other side of things, what if they're evenly distributed, uniformly distributed, where they're not random here, nice little rows and columns? In this type of scenario, if we were to randomly pick a box, well, here we've got two occurrences there. And if we randomly picked another one, well, we've got another two occurrences. And if we picked another one, well, we've got another two occurrences there. And so we don't have that variability. We don't have this random scatter where we're getting zero sometimes and more other times and that kind of thing. And so here again, we do not have a Poisson distribution. The Poisson distribution has been used to model a lot of things. For instance, the number of chocolate chips in a cookie. If we mix up the cookie dough really well, then those chocolate chips will be randomly scattered throughout, and so the number of chocolate chips in a cookie should at least approximately follow a Poisson distribution. Also, the number of calls coming into a call center, although this might be a bit dubious at times. For instance, 911 call centers, if there's an explosion or something, then we have a burst of calls coming in. Also, a classic example here from the Poisson distribution in the world of statistics. It was used to model the number of deaths from horse kicks in the Prussian army. And that would very possibly provide a reasonable approximation of these events occurring randomly and independently of one another. Although if a horse went completely crazy and killed a bunch of people right in a row, there might be little issues there. And one more thing to finish us off here. There is a relationship between the binomial distribution and the Poisson distribution in that the binomial distribution tends toward the Poisson distribution as n tends to infinity, p tends to zero, and n times p stays constant. And as such, the Poisson distribution can provide a reasonable approximation to the binomial distribution if n is large and p is small. And quite often, actually, this real underlying situation is truly a binomial with a very large n and a very small p. And we model it using a Poisson distribution as an approximation. So the Poisson distribution is sometimes described as a distribution to model rare events.